Greetings everybody and welcome to the channel. Today we are going to be checking out a game that I've never played before. And that game, my friends, is Frostpunk, developed and published by 11-bit Studios. It is available on Steam and the Epic Store and is actually free right now on the Epic Store. So I highly recommend you go get it and check it out yourself. This is my first time playing this game. I can see that the game is showing very positive reviews on Steam, but I haven't read any of them. I haven't read any reviews anywhere, seen any playthroughs, watched any tips, so I'm going in totally blind. I hope you'll join me for the experience, and we'll see if this game's any good. Without any further ado, let's begin.
We roam the still, cold world, no horizon in sight. When tides had changed, they changed for all of us, no matter wealth or class. We decided to leave our homes and head north. Slowly, step by step. Finally, the time has come to build the last city on Earth.
So after a pretty cool cinematic introducing the world to us, long story short, everything froze. I don't know why. Let's have a read. We fled from London and crossed the sea to reach the frozen north. It's a bit cheeky. On the way, our convoy was hit by a blizzard and scattered. A handful of us managed to reach the site of this generator only to find it frozen solid and abandoned. Why is no one here? Did any of our people survive the blizzard? Are there any others out there? Whatever we do, we should expect the worst now that the world as we know it has crumbled. So basically, get the generator started. What? What do we do? What's happening? Is this a generator? Yeah, this is the generator. These are our little people. What's his little... What? Oh, they've all got little names. Bert Robertson. Nancy Golding. Oh, so we're supposed to get attached to these people, and then they're going to die. I think that's what's going to happen. So they seem like they have little status panels. Everything is fine. We're resting right now. Not at risk of falling ill. Home. What does it mean, no home? Oh, they don't have any houses. Alright, then so she's married and they've got three children. Okay. And what, can we click on them? Oh, it finds them. Okay, and so it's a people management as well as a city management sort of situation. Alright then. What does discontent mean? 80 homeless people. Stockpile some coal. Turn the generator on. Tutorial. Resource management is crucial to the city's survival. You need coal to power the generator. Wood and steel are necessary for construction and research. So we're looking for coal, okay? And then what do we do once we've found coal? So I've clicked the coal pile, I've clicked on this, and now... Okay, you're moving out to gather the coal? Does this game really drop you into the deep end like this? No real explanation of what to do? Well, I'm down for it, but a little... tutorial would have been nice, a little introduction to what's happening. What do we do with this? Steam level 1. You need 6 coal. The camera turns around. Found that out by accident. So this is our generator, kicking out some steam. Oh, construction, people, health, food, resources, tech. Tent. Oh, camera's a bit weird to get used to. I'll provide some shelter. I'll provide shelter for everyone. You'll have 2 days to provide shelter for 80 people. Okay? Provide shelter for everyone. Didn't I build some tents? No, this thing. Oh no, that's a gathering post. Where's the houses? Did it say that was just for 10 people, but I need to find room for 80 people? Costs 10 wood. Okay, can I gather wood? I don't have 35 available. And then we send 15 out of 15 to go and gather the wood. Okay, go gather the wood. What's this? Steel. I don't want steel right now. We want wood. Oh goodness, camera. Wood. Coal. Coal. Coal deposit. Coal pile. We need some wood. Let's get some wood. We've got 5 people left. What's happening to this? no gatherable resources in range. I feel like the camera rotates the wrong way. Oh, you're just sleeping on the floor. We're out of coal. We'll go get coal then. The generator is shutting down. That means they're going to die, doesn't it? It's shutting down. Already. Go get coal, slackers. I guess this is doing nothing, is that right? Might as well dismantle it then. Oh, we've got more wood for tents. Oh, we can build more. This is still shutting down. Can you not walk faster? It's kind of important. So this is an interesting button. 15 idle engineers. Why, where are they hiding out? Oh, I pressed spacebar to pause it. I didn't even realise. Oh, yeah, changed it there. Okay. We need 4 more tents then, don't we? Oh, can you build it outside? No? Not sure. I did see the building for food. Cookhouse. Turns raw foodstuffs into nutritious meals. Hunter's hut. Hunters based here hunt every night, venturing beyond the city to track their prey in the frozen wastelands. Okay. So I guess we need a cookhouse first of all. What? What does it mean, not adjacent to street? That's adjacent to street. But that is not. Why is that? Okay, well I'm just going to build it here anyway. They work from 6 p.m. till 6 a.m. Initially they bring in 15 units of raw food. Research upgrades to significantly increase hunt yield. Some of it makes a little more sense now. Everyone feels relieved with a roof, even a flapping one over their head. Hope rises. Okay, so we've got hope. Work is needed. There's so much to do and not enough hands to do it. A quick way of addressing this problem is to put our children to work. Well, wouldn't hurt, would it? It's not like they're going to school or something. It's not like they've got Nintendos to play on. Hope will fall slightly, child. Oh, go on, let's do it. We toil all day and now the kids have to work too? Yeah, of course they do. Kids should be learning. Okay, but we don't have a school, do we? We have now gathered the 200 coal that it wanted us to get. The generator hums with reassuring warmth, but we shouldn't take it for granted. If the generator goes down, the city dies. Be mindful of coal reserves. Now, food. There'll be no city if we starve to death. Yeah, I'm already on top of that. Oh, we're not cooking because we didn't assign cooks. We can see the passing of time with the shadows forming. Never noticed that before. We have 5 engineers. Okay. Add new research. Oh, I don't know. What's this? Exploration? Beacon. It said to build a beacon, didn't it? Allows us to send scouts to search the wilderness for goods and survivors and bring them to our city. Yeah, okay, still up. Okay, so you need engineers for the fancy things. Gotcha. I can introduce a new law, okay? Fighting arena. Nothing relieves tension better than watching a few rounds of an all-out slugfest. What? We can add sawdust to meals to make them more filling, although not exactly tasty or healthy. No. Soup. Cook soup instead of full meals. Kind of like the sound of the fighting arena. Okay, let's do it.
New law. A new law has passed.
New law. I'm itching to see a good fight. Fair enough. Build a fighting arena. 15 wood? We do have 15 wood. Not adjacent to street. I haven't figured this part out yet. What makes it adjacent to street or not? Guess that shall do. Oh, so it seems like we can click on construction and then build street. What does building a street cost? What is the cost of this street? Is that doing something? Fancy. Not clicked that one before. I'm in Predator Vision. We'll build a street to it. Is that the idea? So the building streets. There's a little bit of snow left here though. Are you going to go and clear it? Is that what you're going to do? I wish I could zoom in just a bit more. I want to see him do it. That easy, huh? All structures in the city must be connected to the generator with streets, otherwise they won't function. The beacon is built. We're no longer lost and blind. From now on, our people will be able to survey the icy barrens. Is this... Whoa, what's this? What did that do? Oh, cool. Balloon. Oh, so now we get to see our surroundings, the bigger picture. Oh, what's this? What's happening? What was that? What's this? Lost Expedition. Ah, pretty cool. What about this one? An observatory. This peculiar building must be the Arctic Observatory. It's certainly a cool looking game. Scouts have reached the Lost Expedition. What did it do? What did it do? Explore. Okay. Explore. A happy reunion. We enter the camp, appearing out of the driving snow. A choir of excited voices welcomes us. Scouts have returned safely to the city. Oh, what's this? Yeah, how are you going to get down there? I'm just going to jump. People from our convoy reunions. Shouldn't there be other settlements nearby? The first expeditions left London long ago. We will look for the others. I like the idea of the observatory. Let's go. I am running out of food, so I'm constructing another hunter's hut. Yeah, we'll put these 15 spare workers into the hunter's hut. Yeah, that's what we shall do. We need to gather more food, because we are out. The people are starving. 35 people are starving, 24 are homeless. Goodness, this game is just a constant balancing act, isn't it? That's basically what it comes down to. I've got lots of coal, maybe I should stop. Yeah, maybe I should stop with the coal mining. None, stop that. Did I have another one over here? I think I had something else here, didn't I? No. I think if I zoom out, it tells me where they are, doesn't it? Where are my people working? Nowhere right now. Wood, we need wood. That's steel, that's not wood. Cool, what's this? I'm gonna stop them working there. What was it? Wait, where can I click it? Coal, oh, it's depleted anyway. Where was wood again? That's coal. This is wood, surely. Looks like wood. Okay. Begin with that. We do have 10 extra workers. And some children. Okay. Cookhouse is full, but nothing's really happening. Oh, we can't, because we don't have the raw food. Okay. Oh, what now? People are hungry. Yeah, let's feed them. Something's amiss at the observatory. Snow covers the precious instruments, and the dome is open, letting out a thin column of smoke. Someone's inside. Explore. Instead of astronomers, we are met by some of our lost people. They explain that they came here for help but found everybody dead. The astronomers continued their observations until they starved. What was so important for them? They wrote it up in their diaries. The loss of sunlight can't be explained solely by the fouling of the atmosphere by the southern volcanoes. The sun is dimming. Go hunt. No? Are you off to hunt? Oh, okay, I guess that's them going out to hunt. 51 starving people, 24 homeless, 10 sick. Oh wow, look at all the dead people. Not doing a great job, am I? Scouts have reached the crash site. Plenty of priceless supplies in the wrecks of our expedition. Searching among the crates scattered in the snow behind the wrecks, we found the bodies. They're tangled together in a single frozen mass, as if these people were trying to find at least a bit of warmth just before they died. We're going to move on to Gloomy Cave. Sounds intriguing. This cave is or was inhabited. There are a number of footprints leading to its entrance. Several. Beset by beasts. We can hear terrified shrieks coming from a cave. When we come closer, several polar bears turn towards us, blocking the entrance. Oh my goodness. Leave the bears alone, and then the bears will kill the survivors, or... scouts will escort them. Oh my goodness. I feel like we're going to do it. Attack of the bears. It's not very clear what sort of guns we've got or whatever is it. Let's have a look. Attack the bears, do it. When our scouts attacked the bears, the people in the cave joined them and together they drove the beasts away. And they all set out towards the sea. So the scouts have returned and brought more people with them, but now we just have more people to house. Maybe I should have let the bears eat them. In hindsight, I was trying to do the right thing, but... I've got 93 homeless people now. So I have been playing the game for several hours now. This was just a... you know, a first impressions, just a, to give myself a taster. I hope you've found it useful at least. I'm enjoying the game. It seems like constant plate spinning. I maybe took on too many people when I shouldn't have done. Now I've got lots of idle people, but I feel like I could turn it around if I was to continue playing, which I definitely will do at a later date. I think the graphics are very nice, very steampunky. They're doing a good job. The generator itself is rather pleasant, watching the steam come out of it. I am very intrigued by the research that we can unlock. I'm intrigued by the story, how there's other civilizations out there that we're trying to hook up with. I suspect it might be a losing situation for humanity. I think it's just going to keep getting colder and colder and colder until it becomes unmanageable. But I might be wrong, maybe the game does have an actual ending, or, you know, a success that you can reach, a victory condition. But I have enjoyed it greatly, in all honesty. It's constant plate spinning. You know, you can see here that I've got idle workers and engineers because I just haven't built properly. But then again, I couldn't have built better houses because I had to wait for them to finish researching. The technology tree is very interesting. Like I said, I would like to spend some time going through it. You know, it's a little bit strange that you can't hover over and it tells you what different things do, so you have an idea of what to aim for. It's definitely, you know, I could see that it would definitely take a number of trial runs before you figured out what you were supposed to do, like to get off to a good start. But I mean, I'm quite pleased with the progress that I made there. Got a sprawling little colony going on here. You do sort of feel a bit like you're just throwing buildings down without planning it very effectively. But that's more of me though, that's not the game's fault. I don't know how I feel about the lack of a tutorial, or is this the tutorial that I'm doing right now? Is this supposed to be breaking me into it? You know, gently? I can't say it felt very gentle. I like the scouting thing that's going on. I guess eventually, you know, spread out around the map and see what's going on with the rest of the world, or with the rest of the country at least. I guess it's the UK because it said London. At the time of me recording this video, this game is actually free on the Epic Store for the next few days. So, I mean, you've got nothing to lose by downloading it, giving it a whirl. Like I said at the beginning, it is very highly reviewed. There must be people that are, you know, very into this game and spend a lot of hours on it. I could see that you could definitely spend a lot of hours on this game. Right now, discontent is rising and hope is failing. I don't know what happens if you reach zero hope. Does anything bad happen? I would definitely start again though. I will be doing it at a later date. I'll start again. Oh, before we go, let's have a look at the scouts. Let's see what the rest of this story is. Built by the people of Winterhome in AD 1887, the bridge is kept completely snow-free by working automation. Explore. I like these events. These are cool. They keep it interesting. Sending your scouts out on the surface of the planet. We stopped at the edge of a deep, wide ravine, marvelling at the steel bridge spanning it, even more so at the huge automaton sweeping snow from the roadway. It would be possible to send the machine back to our city or disassemble it for resources. I will definitely play later, like I said, I'm very curious. Oh, what's this little event? See, it definitely is, like I said, intriguing, and it likes to keep you hooked with these little events. Why was the bridge deserted? Why wasn't the automaton under the care of an engineer? We'll find out in Winterhome. So now I guess, you know, you're supposed to send the scouts to Winterhome. Oh, what's this? Oh, look, it's like a robot. A steampunky robot. It's very cool. I would say it's a very nice game. It's the sort of game that you could spend hours looking up things on Wiki and trying to find the best build order, the most streamlined way to research things. But I don't like doing that sort of thing when I first start playing a game. I honestly like going in blind and trying to figure things out. That's where the enjoyment is for me. But anyway, I will wrap it up at this point. I definitely will return to this game. I'll play it some more. see if I can get any deeper into the story. But for now, I will stop at that. Hope you've enjoyed the video. I hope you found it useful. Until next time, peace.